Today I talked to another woman from Orange County, California, who's being tortured by family law and Sandy Nunez Leal. This is a crisis. Multiple women are being manhandled, mutilated, desecrated, impoverished, isolated, martyred, murdered, trafficked, milked, and harassed into madness for the benefit of fraudulent men. Her story sounded like mine and Julie Holburn's. And wow, three women being tortured in Orange County, California, in connection to one judge. It's just a good reason to be a little pissed off. A little bit. Especially if those women are pushed to poverty. And if those women are beautiful, do you know what poverty would do to a woman desperate to pay attorney fees? I'm not talking about paying for food. Do you know what poverty would do to a woman desperate to pay attorney fees? So I'm hearing from women who find my name out in the metaverse. My name is out there, attached to everything I am willing to claim, that is written down, published, and expressed by the First Amendment, freedom of speech, to dissent against the government when we're talking about Sandy Nunez Leal. I'm not just the only woman talking about Sandy Nunez Leal today. I'm sure that every judge across the country is talking about Sandy Nunez Leal today. I'm sure that all of them are watching what's happening with Donald John Trump today and whatever money he might have that would trace to her. This woman told me that she researched Sandy Nunez Leal as deeply and as extensively as I did. But I told her more information that she can find on her own, and it affirmed what she was talking about, and it validated what she was going through. She's been going through a lot worse than I have since 2017. And she said she read my writing. She thought I was a lawyer. She called me. And we talked for a good 30 minutes. But what I started to hear in her story was, she's out of money. She's borrowing money. She has to pay mortgages. She has to pay for a couple properties. She used to be rich. She used to be pretty popular and famous. She's even met Todd Spitzer face to face. She was very social. She was very well known across three counties. And I said, girl, go find a legit job. Get on the grid. Because I've almost been pushed so far that prostitution would have been the only answer. I straight up told her that. And just thinking about what kind of evil portal opens up when a woman is tortured that badly. What kind of evil portal is open when she has to be considering that dark path to survive? I do not match up to anybody. I cannot be a whole person with anybody who doesn't understand this. I cannot exist as a whole person, 100% of who I am, with anybody else who does not respect the reality of this. So I've disintegrated into such a hermit because people don't want to hear that part of whatever I have to say, but it's what I have to say. People can't tolerate the negativity of it because they're cushioned from the reality of it. So I'm going around explaining how close I came to becoming a prostitute to survive. I'm going around telling people that you gotta get some sort of income to prevent that from catching you. It's not like these women choose to do that. It's slavery. In America, that kind of life is slavery for everybody involved. And they sell chunks of their soul every time they get paid. I told her that the root cause of this fucking evil is child rape. I told her what Sandy Nunez Leal would open as a key to human trafficking rings across the world in collaboration with Donald John Trump. I told her at the root of this is child rape, abuse, porn. That's what Sandy Nunez Leal sits on. I don't care if this is taken as defamation. If it's true, it's not defamation. If it feels threatening, it's a TikTok explaining a few facts, stories, and feelings. I have a First Amendment right to post this wherever I want to, especially if it helps me calm down and become much less of a ticking time bomb. I mean that figuratively. Most of every day, I'm reminded that that woman sits on a huge web of evil and is immune from accountability and hides behind a mask and hides behind a reputation and hides behind a job to maintain that system. Every night, some kid has to suffer the consequences. And every night, there's more. There are more victims than just that kid. What a woman opens when she chooses evil like that, in my opinion, is worse than what a woman can do to herself if she ever chooses to become a prostitute to survive. So, an influential woman who's actually a fraud, doing this to even more neighbors of mine who find me and explain huge burdens of suffering due to that judge. I just sit around and contain rage that vibrates inside my body like unspeakable, intolerable rage. It comes back every day, and it's not going away, because that judge is still free to do her job. And this woman and I talked about who in the world could hold that judge accountable. We talked about writing things and publishing things. I told her what kind of cyber security issues this whole county has and why we can't do that. I told her to survive, you should get a job with a stand-up company that's straightforward and honest. I don't think she's gonna do that, but she borrowed a bunch of money to pay a bunch of bills, and that is the number one way to fall down the rabbit hole. I at least have her number, and she has mine, and she knows my real name. I can't wait anymore. This is